Hi, this is Fern G.Z. Carr, website www.ferngzcarr.com. Here's a set of poetry mini-interviews. In April and May of 2019, I was interviewed by Thomas White for his literary blog, Poetry Mini-Interviews, very short interviews with poets. A series of questions were posed weekly to a variety of poets. It is quite intriguing to read the responses by each of them as they relate to the craft of poetry from their unique perspectives. I present my replies here. Enjoy! Thursday, April 4th, 2019, Part 1. Fern G.Z. Carr is a former lawyer, teacher, and past president of both the local branch of the BC Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals and Project Literacy Kelowna Society. She is a full member of the League of Canadian Poets and has served as the League's Poet in Residence mentoring young writers. A Pushcart Prize nominee, Carr composes and translates poetry in six languages, including Mandarin. She has been published extensively worldwide from Finland to Mauritius. Honors include being cited as a contributor to India's Prakalpana literary movement, having had her work taught at West Virginia University, having a Juno-nominated musician set her poetry to music and perform it, and an online feature in the Globe and Mail. Her poem, I Am, was chosen by the former Parliamentary Poet Laureate as Poem of the Month for Canada. Carr's debut poetry collection, Shards of Crystal, Silverbow Publishing 2018, is available on Amazon. Carr is thrilled to have one of her poems currently orbiting the planet Mars aboard NASA's MAVEN spacecraft. www.ferngzcarr.com. Why is poetry important? Poetry is an intrinsic part of our culture. That said, its definition is somewhat elusive. What strikes one person as poetry or poetic can mean something entirely different to someone else. Yet, despite the form or interpretation, I have always maintained that poetry is compact storytelling. As such, it is an integral part of who we are as a people. Thursday, April 11th, 2019, Part 2. How does your work first enter the world? An idea will pop into my mind at any time of day or night and demand to be transformed into a poem. Some poems are more tenacious than others and will keep nagging me until I write them. Others are content to reside in my notebook of ideas until the mood is right and I'm able to do them justice. Thursday, April 18th, 2019, Part 3. How important is music to your poetry? Music is exceptionally important to me as a poet. Writing and music are all parts of a whole. Poetry is music and music is poetry. Rhythm, tone, dynamics, etc. They are just different means of expression. As a longtime pianist and chorister, some of my work definitely has been influenced by music. I was very honored to have been nominated for a Pushcart Prize by the Worcester Review for my poem, Cool Jazz. I wrote that poem on a music staff so as to mimic a page of sheet music. Thursday, April 25th, 2019, Part 4. How do you know when a poem is finished? Do you have a social group or writer's group that you work ideas and poems with? I don't believe that a poem is ever finished. Instead, I would say that while a poem might appear to be complete at a certain point in time, given some distance, there is always room for change. On average, I typically do at least 7 different final drafts of a poem before I'd even consider it done. I sometimes will share it with friends and family because I enjoy hearing their interpretation. Often, their take on what I've written isn't necessarily what I intended. That subjectivity, though, is a fundamental part of the beauty and pleasure of poetry. Thursday, May 2nd, 2019. Part 5. What are you working on? I have recently finished working with my publisher, Silver Bow Publishing, on the release of my poetry collection, Shards of Crystal. I am therefore currently focusing on readings and sharing my poetry with others. I'm still submitting my work to journals and anthologies worldwide, which I do on a regular basis. That is, in addition to my ongoing personal challenge to be published in all 50 USA states. I've been published in most of them so far, but am working towards 50. I've always composed foreign language poetry and will often translate it into English. I'll sometimes start with one of my English poems and then translate it into another language. My preference, though, is to write the poem in my language or languages of choice and then translate it into English. It seems to come across as more genuine that way. All that said, I am attempting to write more poetry in Mandarin. It is such a great language. Typing the Chinese characters on the computer can tend to be pretty time-consuming, though. Thursday, May 9th, 2019. Coda. If I were to share my experience with emerging poets, I'd distill it down to the following. Read poetry by many different poets who write in many different styles. Write because you truly want to write. Poetry is a labor of love. It is not about financial gain. Persist, persist, persist. The rest will naturally follow. Acknowledgements. Poetry mini interviews conducted and curated by Thomas White. Interviews courtesy of Thomas White. Thanks very much for watching my video. If you enjoyed it, feel free to like and please be sure to subscribe. For more poetry, my book Shards of Crystal is available on Amazon. Thanks again and stay tuned for a new video every Wednesday.